Jessie from Brighton Kettlebells here, here to help you to maintain your kettlebell fitness whilst we're on lockdown at the moment. Shame we can't be here face to face and that I have to talk to a camera and can't interact with you guys, but hopefully this will be as well received as the last one. So this is designed for people of any level of kettlebells. A little bit of kettlebell experience is probably best. I haven't included anything too complicated, but some kind of idea of, or if you've had some experience before, is probably not such a bad idea. I am going to give alternatives for those of you that are more of a beginner level, and at the same token, I'm going to give more advanced versions of each exercise for those of you that are more experienced. A same format, so we're going to do warm up and mobility, pulse raiser, and then we're going to do we're going to use the kettlebell to warm up even further, and then we're going to gradually make the sets harder to a complex style, and then we're going to have a finisher, which today is a Tabata. I had a lot of messages about the finisher last time, and hopefully this is just as good. Now, all you need is one kettlebell, or if you've got two, that might be desirable for some of the exercises, if you're weaker on one side, and some water. I'm going to be doing the time, and since it's for time, if some of the exercises you think are slightly easier, then just go that little bit faster, try and get a few more reps in of good quality. If you're a beginner, go a bit slightly slower pace in the time. So the time will be 30 seconds effort, 10 seconds rest. Okay, so I'll try not to talk too much more and let's get on with the workout. Let's go. Okay, I've got a little bit of music on in the background, but you can use your own, but I find it a bit strange without any. So let's go, we're gonna circle the hips. So let's just get hips a little bit warmed up. And the other way. So if you're doing this first thing in the morning, you might be feeling a little bit stiff. If you're doing this a bit later on in the day, you might feel a little bit more juicy already, unless you've been sitting down at a desk, in which case it's really important to get moving. Good. Feet a little bit closer together, and then we're just going to twist around the body. So first of all, just use your spine to try and get movement all the way across your back and your torso. Just try and keep the hips facing forward for now. And feel the twist around your spine, all the way up your thoracic spine, so behind your rib cage. Just want to leave that neck alone though. And then now we're just going to keep the knees soft, and you can allow yourself to be a bit more floppy. So you can twist and then start to let your feet take you around a bit more so the hips can move now. Good. Next, we're going to add a little squat into that. Squat down, round, sweeping the floor. If you've got monkey arms like mine, they might go really close. Now, you may notice, I've got no shoes on. I like to do kettlebells without shoes. I like to feel the whole of the ground. If you've never tried it before, and you're doing your home, now is quite a good time to learn. Good. Shake the arms out. We're going to roll the shoulders back. And roll those shoulders forwards. Good. going to go diagonally. Taking the heels to the bottom. Just warming up the fronts of the thighs. This is why I need the music, to keep some kind of rhythm, because I'm not naturally gifted with that. This time we're going forwards, lifting up, flexing. And then we go back to heel kick. This time, bringing up the pace a little bit. Alright, knee. Speed it up. And then knees up, high knees. Faster. Feel that heart rate rising. Good. Go back to it. We're going to jog on the squat and twist the hips. Light on the toes. And then we're going to pretend we're skipping. Just taking the toes out in front. Get yourself. Enough of that. Right, we're going to take the legs a little bit wider. And we're going to lunge to the side, so lateral lunge. Warming up the legs. Hip flexors. Good, keep going. And we're going to touch the floor now. You should start to feel that in your legs. 3, 2, and 1. Next, we're going to start with the inch wise. We did this last time, so we're going to walk the hands out and back. Warming up the hamstrings and the core, hold it tight there. And then we're going to come back. Spin the legs, hold it tight, arming back in. When you come up, squeeze the bottom. This time, we're going to reach above the head. Good. Reach above the head. Now this time we're going to add on. We did this before. Holding it there. Tap, tap. Come back in. Out. This time, one foot comes out. I'm going to twist around. Back in. Foot comes back. If you can't get your foot all the way to there, just come as far as you can. It's fine. I'm already quite warm from practice. Alternating sides. So we're getting a twist in the torso, opening up the hips. One more on each side. Now we're going to go back to shoulder taps. Come here if you want to, come down on your knees. It's just a warm up. Good. Come back up, stand. Last part of the warm up, we're going to twist and lunge. Lunge forward, twist over the front leg. Twist over the front leg. Trying to stay in frame here. It's blowing a gale outside and raining on and off, but a bit of hail. Good. This time I'm going to twist over. Side stretch. So if you look at me, we're going to twist over. Good. And one more. Good. Give yourselves a shake. Okay. Just going to have a drink of water. So, we did this variation of this in the last workout. Okay, so the first part, 30 seconds work, 10 seconds rest, 3 exercises. I'm going to do it twice through. And these are kind of kettlebell moves which are helping to warm up the body a little bit more. So we're going to do a slingshot, which is around the world to some of you. We're passing the kettlebell around the body. Then we're going to do halos. And then we're going to do a deadlift, but with one arm. So, looks something like this. Slingshot. Keep your tummy nice and tight. Halos. Around the head. So the first round we do one way, the second round we do the other way. And then we're going to do a deadlift with a single arm. So come down to here, standing up. So just practicing that hinge movement for the first round. Hinging back. Again, squeeze the shoulder blades together. And then the second round, we will do the other side. Okay, so 30 seconds on the clock. Let's go, slingshot. Passing it round the body. Remember which way you went. I probably forget myself. Chest lifted. Squeezing the shoulder blades down, keeping them away from your ears. Try to keep as still as possible, like a statue with hanging in wobbly arms. Here comes the rain and time. Good, we've got 10 seconds rest, then we're going into halos. So if you can only hear rain, let's go. That's because it's absolutely chucking it down. Again. Try and keep your body in a nice straight position. Control. And draw a halo, a circle around the head. Angels. So you've warmed up the shoulder girdle there, upper back. Good. Now we're going for the single arm deadlift. So I always say choose your weakest side first, hinging of the hips backwards. Good. So when you get to that point where you can feel it in your hamstrings, come back up. On the way back up, squeeze the legs. Good. Time to go back to the slingshots. We're going in the opposite direction. Now, see if I can remember which way I went last time. I think I went the other way. Good. Yep, I think that's right. So this is good for the core. Hold it nice and tight. Draw that belly button in towards your spine. Squeeze the buttocks. Keep relaxed. Chest lifted, but no flaring of the ribs. You'll keep hearing me repeat that, but that's to stop you from arching your lower back. Good, and time. Now, halos. Let's see if I can remember this time which way I went. So if you want to, you can have your feet further apart, just to give you a more stable base. Harder, your feet together. Keep the hips forward. Try and stop the body from twisting, just the top. Just use your shoulders and upper back and your arms. This is a test on your core and the mobility. Woo! Bit juicy, good. Okay, single leg deadlift on the other side. So practice that hip hinge that we need to swing with. Come down, up. Open the door with your bum. Try and keep the kettlebell close to the body. Keep the shoulder blades squeezed together so you don't let the shoulders round forward. Chin tucked. Squeeze that bum. And time, well done. So that was your first round over. Hopefully you're feeling quite warm and have practiced the movement pattern for the swing there. Let me just turn that off for a sec, it's annoying me. So the next round of exercises, we're doing single arm swing, single leg deadlift, which is a little bit tricky, and a bent over row. So we're looking something like this. So we're doing one arm or one side each round, two rounds, so that means we do once on each side. So single arm swing, we're taking it through. Remember as last time, open the door with your arm, pop the hips forward. Now if you're not quite ready to do single arm swings, you can do single arm, you can do double arm swings. So the Russian swing. So start with your weakest side first. Then we're going to do single leg deadlifts. So start with feet hip width apart. We're going to take that foot back a little bit. And then we're going to hinge from those hips again. So the hinge pattern is really important. So you're going to send that leg, the back leg backwards, keeping the foot flexed. So this is a test of your balance. Just like that. So keep that standing leg soft. If you're not quite there yet, you can do a deadlift with both hands. Okay? Then we're going to do a bent over row. So you can choose your stance. In stance, split stance with the back toes into the floor, heel raised, bringing the elbow back, squeezing, and the movement starts in the back muscle. So pull with the back, elbow comes. Or you can use feet side by side and pull that way. Okay? As long as your hips stay square to the floor. Two rounds. Let's go. So single arm swing. Remember that hip hinge. Breathe out as you come up. Just 30 seconds, remember. Good. Single leg deadlift now. Same size as your hand. Good. Leg goes back. Lower that kettlebell down. Pop forward. So try and keep your back muscles squeezed together and slide it down your leg. Try not to let the shoulders round forward. You don't need to touch the ground. You should feel this in your bum and your quads. Good. Oh, my balance. Good. Then we're going to use the same arm and do the bent over row. Let's go. this really easy. Get a heavier kettlebell. Of course, if you want to repeat this on your own, then you can do longer time. Stay soft on those knees. Good. But can't guess what we're going to do next. Same on the other side. Single arm swings first. Let's go. Now, I've seen loads of people doing exercise every day. Be mindful of what you're doing. Mix it up. Do some mobility and stretching one day, slightly more conditioning on other days. Get your rest in. Daily activity, yes. Daily hardcore exercise, absolutely not. Single leg deadlifts. The last thing you need is to be injuring yourself. If you're not working out, maybe it's time and you're not moving around as much, like myself. Factor in that into what you eat. Maybe eat a few less carbohydrates. Working your back here, shoulders, those legs getting a bit of a workout as well. Good. So, that's those two done. Who wants to do that one again? Let's go. Single arm swings. Surprise! Try not to rest your arm on there. Rest when you need to. This is your class. Go at your own pace, you don't have to keep up with me. Take it how you need to right now. If you're feeling fatigued, slow it down. Single leg deadlifts. Do what is good for you today. My head is not in there. Plank. I'm using a light kettlebell today, so I've got to do some more stuff filming after this. Let's go. Single leg deadlifts. How are you finding these? Tricky, aren't they? You've got to balance. Can't tell you how much harder it is to talk as well at the same time. Great for balance. Developing even strength on both sides. Last exercise in this group. Let's go. Keep those hips square to the floor. Try not to twist around the body. If you need to rest, just rest. It's okay. Yes. Well done, everybody. Twice around was quite tough. Okay. Next set of exercises. Just got to check out my board. Have a drink of water, everyone. Okay. So, we're gonna work on cleans this time. We're gonna do a clean, a goblet squat, and then a push press. And then on the lift time, we're gonna put these together. Okay. So the clean, we did last time again. So on this, we're gonna dead clean it from the floor. So picking the kettlebell up in, with two in the thumb corner, zipping up. So you're gonna zip up, catch it in the grip of your arm. So imagine you're zipping up a coat, squeezing 50-pound note under your arm so you don't wanna drop it, and catching it gently in the grip of your arm. So from here, zipping up, catch it. Ooh, that was good. Slow motion. Let's go, we're gonna go up. And then we're gonna take it to the floor to switch sides. Down. And switch. So that's your clean. 30 seconds of alternating cleans. Then back to two-handed exercise. This time we're going to goblet squat. So take your feet as wide as you need to. I've got quite long femurs, so mine are fairly wide, but this is a point where you need to learn a sort of squat position that works well for you. So squat down, bring up. Squat down, drive through the heels, push up. Explosively stand up. Then we're gonna go to a push press on either side, the one side followed by the other. So hold it in rack position here, and we're going to push it above the head, bending our knees first. So dip and drive, dip, drive. So we're going to dip, push it up against the, over above the head, excuse me. Bend up, okay? So the push will help you to get it above the head. So that's a nice little tip if your arms are getting fatigued as well from being overhead pressing, is to push it up. Okay. Just gonna do one round of those, by the way. Okay. We'll start off with our alternating cleans, so let's go. Dead clean. Switch sides. So catch it, bend the knees. Zip it up. Zip it up. Now, it takes a bit of practice before you stop clonking it against your wrist. But my top tip is to keep it close to the body. One more, just back. So keep it close to the body. If you swing it out, that's when you're gonna clonk it on your wrist. Good, get ready. We're going to goblet squat. Let's go. So keep your chest lifted. Some people might be able to get down lower than others. Time. Good. Let's bring the kettlebell into rack position. Then a push press. Wicked side first. Let's go. Push. Dip down. Push. Dip down and push. Dip down. Push. Good, keep going, nearly there. Save me from another rep. 10 seconds rest, switch sides. So you can either lean it there or just pass it over. Let's go. Dip, push it above the head. So when you lock out, make sure your forearm is by your ear. If you need to rest, just rest here in rack position. Just keep going. I've got bad shoulder this side, so I'm just resting for a couple of reps before I take it back to dip. Good. Back to the cleans. Here we go. Back down to the floor, switch arms. To really pop up, push through those legs to give you lots of power. Notice how I'm using my breath. To create a little bit of core tension and time. Coming up next, we've got the goblet squat. Whew, a bit out of puff now. Good, keep going. So if you're finding this really easy, you can take up the pace. I'm kind of going at a medium pace right now. That's because I'm talking. If you've got a heavier kettlebell, go slower. Breathe in as you go down. Good. Now onto the harder one. Good, let's go. Push press. You're going to notice all the silly faces that I make and I'm working out. Try not to lean back. If you're finding you're arching your back, maybe take a little rest or use a lighter kettlebell. Be conscious about what you're doing. Note every little thing. Good. Quality, remember. Don't want to be throwing ourselves all over the place. Okay. Let's go. Dip. Up. Dip. Come underneath. Okay, like I said before, this is my dodgy shoulder. I'm going to rest it out, but you keep going. Hopefully, you're feeling energized. Let's go one more. Good. That's that round done. Well done. Have a drink of water. Good, we're nearly there everybody, for our last round. So, we're gonna finish, like I said before, I'm just gonna change my timer, we are doing Tabata finisher. So Tabata is 4 minutes 20 seconds effort, 10 seconds rest. So in the 20 seconds of work, we're going to be working really, really hard as we can. And in the 10 seconds of rest, we're going to be doing just that, just standing still. So the idea is in the 4 minutes, we work really hard as we can in the 20 seconds, and rest completely, stand still, catch your breath for 10 seconds. And then when it's over, we're going to do our stretch and cool down. So the three exercises we're going to switch between, pardon me. So we are going, I'm going to do this one. So we're going to switch, excuse me, I'm just going to tell you. So we're going to switch between a squat and we're going to switch over. So it's a squat and a switch. So you'll see what I mean. Squat down, hit the kettlebell up, push through the feet and switch hands at the top. Then go to the floor. So sped up, it's like this. Catch in. Okay. Then we're going to do a swing but with a side step. So it looks like this. So we're coming through the legs. Okay. And then we're going to lie the kettlebell down. So it's having a little bit of a chill time. I'm going to touch toes. We'll do toe taps on the kettlebell. And then those are your three exercises. So squats, switches, swings with a side step, and toe taps. So we're going to get going. So we're going to go in 3, 2, and 1. So work as hard as you can. Go. So use the heaviest kettlebell that you've got. Push those legs. Push. That's it. Then it's side step with a swing. Let's go. Oh, I didn't get that one right, did I? Good. Good, keep going. Pop those hips forward. And time. Good. Lay the kettlebell down for a rest. Ready to toe tap. Good. Drive the arms. Let's go. Go faster if you can. 20 seconds of really hard work. Let's go. Kettlebell comes back up. Get ready to squat. Let's go. Squat and switch. Keep up the pace. My glasses are about to fall off, so you might be afraid to laugh at in a minute. Good, kettlebell goes down. Someone has a lie down, but not us just yet. We're nearly there. Catch your breath, let's go. Drive those arms. my lack of coordination here. Brain fart. Good. Near there, everybody. We've got two more rounds left. Go. Push through those heels. Good. Catch it. Who's feeling their legs burn? Good. If you're just doing a normal swing here, without the sidestep. Good. So many benefits to kettlebells. I think that might be it. I will lie them down just in case. That is it. You didn't need to lie down, darling. Oh. Shh. Right. Grab a drink, give yourself a bit of a wipe down with a towel. Let's see what I'm feeling. Sun's now come out and now it's again, once again, it's like a sauna in here. Good. So, once you've got your breath back, keep walking around a little bit. We're going to take a lie down on the floor. Okay. Take those feet in front. I don't have any room here. But if you, I'm going to take my arms out to the side. But if you want to, you can stretch them over above the head. Give your whole body a stretch from head to toe. Point the toes, point the fingers. Give them a bit of a wiggle. Take some deep breaths in and out. So let yourself go a bit floppy. Couple of breaths here. Good, and a bend. The knees. Take one foot, your ankle across your knee. Push away. Push that knee away. Keeping both bum cheeks on the floor. That's my anatomical phrase. Push the hand into the knee. Good, with the same leg, you're going to take it up into the air. Take behind the hamstring on the back of the thigh, flex the toes and pull the leg towards you. You should feel that in your hamstring, the back of your leg, your upper leg. If you don't feel it there, take a small bend in the knee. Keep that toe flexed towards your face. So when you feel your leg shaking, keep it there, hold it there for a bit. When it stops shaking, you can bring it in a tiny bit more. Just use your breath. Same leg, take the ankle back onto the opposite knee and grab around either the shin or behind the leg and pull that leg towards you. And you should feel the glute stretch. Slight fine hip stretch on the opposite side. We're going to take the knees deep back down and we're going to shift the hips over to one side and then take the knees
onto the floor and look over the opposite shoulder. Back chest, nice little twist. Keep the shoulders on the floor, arms out to the side or in like a cactus position. Opening up the chest a little bit. Good. Same again on this side. Foot across the ankle, push the knee away. Both buttocks on the floor. Breathe in and out. Stretch the hips a tiny bit. Hopefully you're starting to feel yourself calming down now. Feeling a little bit more relaxed. Good, we're going to get those hamstrings again now. Take behind the thigh. Flex those toes towards you, pull in towards the body. Once again, if you feel it behind in your knee, not in your hamstring, bend the knee slightly. Good, back, ankle back across. Take behind either the thigh or in front of the shin. Get a glute stretch on the opposite side. Good, feet back on the floor. Shift the hips over and drop the knees over to the opposite side. Look over, see my beetroot red face now. Keep the shoulders onto the floor. So we open up the chest, nice twist on the spine and the hips. Good, let's hug the knees into the chest, rock from side to side, and then roll over onto your right side and come up. Push yourself up. Come into like a tabletop position. We're just going to do a cat-cow, so breathing in, looking up. Breathing out. Arching the back, tucking the chin. Just go a couple of rounds at your own pace. Down. Good, next we're just going to do a little stretch of hip flexors. Tuck the tailbone under here and we're just going to lean forward slightly, feel that stretch in the front of the leg. Switch to the other side. So get a stable base, feet a bit width apart, tuck the tailbone under, lean forward slightly, and you should feel that in the hip flexor on the other side. Lean forward until you get to that point where you can feel it. Down. We're going to stretch the chest here with the chest, hands is the small of the back, lift the chest up, bring the elbows towards each other, deep breath in and out, good, and then we're going to do the back here, so take opposite, take the arms out wide, sweep them together, push the hands away, drop the chin to the chest. Stretch that upper back, really push the hands away. So here we're also giving your quads a bit of a stretch too, the front of your thighs. You come round, stay here, you're gonna keep stretching those quads. Let's take the arm across the body, look over the shoulder. Try not to stretch it the neck too much though when you do this. Just gaze. Now let's do the tricep, back of the arm. Just take it down, take the hand on the back and just pull. Slightly backwards. Good, let's do the same on the other side. Stretching the shoulders. And then the tricep. Good, and now we're just going to do a little neck exercise. So I'm going to take ear towards the shoulder and place the hand on the ear and push that ear in towards the hand. So rather than wrenching your head that way, you're going to push into the hand. It's not really like a stretch. So you might not feel a huge amount, but it should feel like it's releasing, if nothing else. Good. Same on the other side. The ear goes down towards your shoulder. Take hand over to this ear and push in to this ear with your head. Good. And then we're going to do the back. We're going to push our head backwards into the hands. So pull the hands towards you, push the head back really gently. So you're not putting in like aggressively, just like 20% effort. So this is a really nice one to do at your desk as well, if you sit at a desk all day. And then we do the opposite, where you push in towards your head, your forehead into your hands, and your hands into your forehead. So if you sit at your desk all day, this is a really nice one to do for your neck. Get a sore neck. Good, then roll the shoulders back and roll the shoulders forward. Give yourself a clap. Now, make sure that for the rest of the day you stay well hydrated. No doubt you've sweated a lot, like me. If you're finding yourself snacking on loads of different foods at the moment, make sure you're eating foods that's really satisfying, proteins and fruit and vegetables and other foods with loads of fibre in. That should keep you fuller for longer and keep some of those cravings away. If you want some more nutrition advice, then just ping us a message and we can answer those questions in the group. Thanks very much for watching. Have a great day.